Dear student, in last few videos, we discussed concept of entity relationship data model. Entity relationship data model, we have the three main component: entity, attribute, and relationships. Now, we are having the concept of enhanced ER model or enhanced entity relationship model. This one model is the extension of existing ER models with the new modeling constraint. Whenever we are providing the extensions, this one extension of the entity type. We are having the extension in entity types with the new modeling constraint. Those constraints can be in the form of supertype, subtype, and the relationship between the supertype, subtype relationship. What is now we are having the concept of the supertype and subtype. What is the subtype? The entity type that share the common properties. Entity type that share the common attribute with its supertype is called subtype. Each subtype inherit attribute from its supertype. In addition, it may have special attribute. Attribute of one subtype may distinct from any other subtype. So when we say that we are having the concept of the subtype is just that inherit the attribute from its supertype, and the attribute of the subtype are distinct from the attribute of any other subtype. Now, what is a supertype? A generalized entity type that subdivide into the several specialized entities. The entity type that has a relationship with one or more subtypes. Supertype has those attributes which are common to their subtypes. As instance of the subtype is also the instance of the supertype. Let me take the example. Let me say we are having one entity type is there. Here we are having the specialized entity type. This one general entity type, that is a supertype. This one is divided into several specialized entity types. So one general entity type is divided into several specialized entity types. So specialized entity types are called sub-entity types, while general entity type is called the super entity type. So what is the super entity type? General entity type that can be subdivided into the several specialized entity type. The general entity type having the relationship with one or more subtype. Here we see that attribute shared by all entities. What in super entity types? Common attributes. The attribute that is shared among the all the sub entity types. While here, when we see that subtypes, attribute unique to the subtype ones, we are having the distinct attributes are there. Attribute of some types, some subtypes are distinct to the attribute of the other subtypes, and the common attribute that will be used as a on the super entity type. Here we see that we are having the identifier is there. Even identifiers in the super entity type, right? That is common among the different subtypes. Identifier is used. That is used as a super type. Now that is common for all the subtype. Now another thing, we are having the relationship in which all the instance participates. The relationship with the supertypes, in which all the instance that can be the instance of the supertype or instance of the any participating subtypes are participate. While the relationship with any subtype is only specialized versions, is related to only specific subtype. Let here we are having the example supertype and subtypes. We see that supertype subtype relationship, the attribute that are shared by all the entity including identifier are associated with the supertype. Here we have the three different entity types are there. We see that attribute that are common that are shared by all the entity types including identifier are associated with the supertype. So here attribute is a one. Second one attribute, we see that imply names, imply number, that is the identifier that is shared by all the entity. Next one, imply name is shared among all the entity. Address is shared among all the entity. Date hired is shared among the hourly employee, salaried employee, and the contract employee. Now here we are having few attributes are there. Like we are having hourly rate and the hourly employee. Here we are having the annual salary and stock options. Here we are having the contract numbers. And billing credits. These attributes are unique to the particular subtypes. And these attributes should be associated with the subtypes. So how we can use it? We see that the attributes that are shared by all the entity types, including identifier, these attributes like employee number, employee name, address, and date hired, that should be associated with the supertype, while the attributes that are unique to the particular subtypes are associated with the subtypes. Now here we are having the example of this one. We see that in supertypes, all the attributes as all the employee subtype have employee number, employee name, address, and date hired. So attribute that are common and shared by all the sub-entity types that are associated with the supertype. Now another, we see that attributes that have the entity type that have a distinct attributes, those distinct attributes are associated with the subtype. So here in hourly employee, we are having the hourly rate is associated with the hourly employee. Annual, we are having the annual salary and stock options. These are associated with the salary employed, and the consultant contract number and billing rate, these are associated with the consultant. So these are the unique attribute, distinct attribute, and associated with a specific entity type or subtype. Now next one, we are having the supertype level and subtype level relationship. First we are having the supertype level relationship. The relationship at the supertype levels indicate that all the subtype will participate in the relationship. Here we see that patient is there, is cared for responsible physicians. A physician cured the patient. So this one is a relationship at the subtype levels. It indicate that all the subtype will participate in this one relationship. Here we are having the two different subtypes are there. Outdoor patients are resident patients. So whenever we are having the relationship at the supertype level, all the subtype will participate in the relationship. While when we see that we are having the relationship at the subtype levels, subtype level relationship, the instance of the subtype may participate in a relationship that is unique to that subtype. Here, relation is associated with the resident patient's entity. In resident patient entity subtypes, we are having the relationship is there, is assigned, and here entity type is there, bed. So, bed is a relationship, here is assigned, is a relationship that is associated with the specific subtype, and that is the resident patient. No other entity type is participating in this one relationship. Only specific entity type is participated in a relationship. So whenever we are having the supertype level relationship, all the subtype will participate in that one relationship. While the relationship at the subtype level, only specific participating entity type or subtype will be participate in that relationship. Both subtype participate in the relationship is cared for, while only resident patient subtype participate in the relationship. So is assigned is a subtype level relationship, while is cared for is a supertype level relationship. Now, whenever we have to develop the supertype subtype level relationship or supertype subtype relationship, we are having the two different techniques are there. First one is generalization and second one is a specialization. What is a generalization? The process of defining more general entity type from the set of the more specialized entity type. Whenever we are having the different general entity types are available, from all of those general entity types, we are having the different specialized entity types are available. From all of those specialized entity types, defining the general entity type, that concept is called generalization. And when we say that we are having the generalization, that is generalization is a bottom-up approach. Here we are having the specialized entity types. First one, we are having the hourly employee. Second one, we are having the salary employed. Third one, we are having the contract employee. These are the specialized entity types. This one, we are having the bottom-up process. All of these specialized entity types, first we have to identify the common attribute among these specialized entity type. Is there any common attribute is available among these specialized entity types? So first we have to identify that one. So here in this one, we are having in these specialized entity types, we are having the three different attributes are there, including identifiers. What are those? Employee number, employee names, address, and date hired. These are the attributes that are common in all the specialized entity types. If attributes are common, then what we have to do? We have to form supertype subtype level relationship. We identify here the common attribute. The common attributes are here. We say that we are having the employee number, employee names, address, in higher grade. So we have to create one entry type that is a general entry type that containing all of these common attributes. And the name of this one entry type should be here imply. Attribute imply numbers, names, and attributes. Example is given, so let's see that one. So here imply is the entity type that contain the common attributes, while the attributes that are not common in any of the participating entity types, those attributes are used over here in the additional attributes are used in the subtype. So suppose whenever in generalization, that is a bottom-up process where we are having the specialized entity type. From all of those specialized entity type, we have to define the supertype and subtypes. We have to define the general entity types, bottom-up approach. Let's take another example. We are having in generalization process, we are having the different entry types are available. These entry types are here: car, truck, and motorcycles. We have to identify the common attribute. And generalization, we are having the specialized entry types are there. In car, we are having vehicle ID identifier, truck vehicle ID, and motorcycle, we are having the vehicle ID. Price is available in the car. Price is also common in the truck entity, and price is common in the motorcycle. We are having another English displacement. English displacement and English displacement is a common attribute. Vehicle names that is available in all the three specialized entity types. Number of passengers in car, that is not common. This one is distinct to the car entity. So we are having capacity and the truck entity, that is not common. Cab type, that is not common. While in motorcycle entity, we couldn't find anything, any other attribute that is not available in the other participating entity type. So we have to use one supertype. The name of that one supertype should be vehicles. That could tell attributes. We are having the attribute like vehicle ID, price, engine displacement, vehicle names, make and model. These are the common attributes in the supertype. While in the subtypes, in car entity, we see that we are having the attribute number of passengers, while in the truck subtype, we are having the attribute capacity, and we are having the cab type. While we will not define the motorcycle subtype. Why? Because it has no unique attribute. Whenever we don't have attribute, unique attribute, then we don't need to define the motorcycle entity types. Here we created one car, and second one we are having the truck entity type. That is concept is called generalization. Next one, specialization. The process of defining one or more subtype of the supertypes in forming subtype supertype relationship or supertype subtype relationship. We are having one entry type, and that one entry type is a supertype. Or we are having one entry type stop. From this one stop entry types, we may be able to define the different subtype. It's a top-down process. Each supertype is found based on some distinguished characteristics. Let me, here we are having the table is available. If we see in this one table, we are having staff number, name, position and salary. Here one attribute is here, manager start date. This one contains only few values are there. We are having the bonuses also for the few values. Sales area is available only for the few. And car allowance is only for the few. If we checked, values are the missing over here. Sale area is not available. Where we are having the manager start dates. Here nothing is available. Now, when we see that we are having the sales allowances there, we are having the car allowances there. So, staff numbers, name, position, and salary, these are the common attributes. These are the, normally we say that required attribute. These attributes are needed for all type of the staff. Why? When we say manager start date and bonus, that person is a manager. And these attributes are associated only with the managers. And sales area and car allowance, these attributes are associated with the salesman. So man is we are having the supertype, and supertype we are having the staff, and we have to define the common attribute that will be for all of those common attributes. We have to create one the supertype that must contain the attribute staff number, identifier, name, position and salary, while other subtype attribute should be like we are having for the managers, we are having the manager's start date and bonus, and salesmen we are having the sales area and car allowance. Now we are having constraint and supertype subtype relationship. There are two main type of the constraints at the supertype and subtype relationship. First one, we are having the completeness constraint, and second one, disjointness constraint. First, completeness. It addresses the questions of whether an instance of the supertype must be the member of at least one subtype. If we are having the instance of the supertype, whether that is the instance of one entity type, subtypes or not. When we see that we are having concept of the completeness. In completeness, further we are having the two different types. First one is a total specialized, and second one is we are having the partial specialized. Total specialized, we see that each entity instance of the super entity type must be the member of some subtypes, one or more subtype in a relationship. If we are having instance of the supertypes, that and total specialized rules, instance of the supertype that must be the members of some of the subtypes, that can be the members of one or many subtype, that is called total specialized rule. It can be represented by we are having the double lines extended from the entity type to a circle. How we can represent it? We have to use it can be represented by the double line extended from the super entity type to the circle. Whenever we are having the double lines that is extended from the supertype to the circle, it means that follow the total specialized rules. Each entity instance of the supertype that must be the instance of the any of the subtypes. That we are having the patient is there, that must be either the patients of the outdoor patients or resident patients. We have no option that we are having the patients and that is not included in any of both any of these category. That can be outpatient or resident patients. Patient must be either in outpatients or resident patients. That is called total specialized rules. Second one, we are having the partial specialized rules. Each instance of the supertype is allowed not to be belong any subtypes. That we are having the instances here. Instance of the supertype, it is not necessary that it must be the part of the any that must be the member of any of the subtype. Let previously we check one diagrams. We see that we are having the motorcycle is there. All the attributes that belong to the motorcycles are available over here. The vehicles for the motorcycles, it cannot appear on instance of any of the subtypes. If motorcycle is there, that is neither car, that is neither truck. If vehicle is motorcycle, it can't appear in the instance of any subtype. So we see that each entity instance of the subtype is allowed not to belong to any subtype. So whenever the instance of the subtype that is not represented the member of the subtype. To represent the partial specialization rule, we are having the single line extended from the entity type to the circle. These are the rules. First one, we are having the completeness constraints. In completeness constraint, we are having the two total specialized rules and partial specialized rules. Now, we are having another concept. Disjoint constraint. In disjoint constraints, we are having the two the constraints address the questions whether an instance of the subtype may simultaneously be a member of two or more subtypes. If we are having instance of one subtype, that is that can be the members of two subtypes or not at the same time. We are having the two different types. First one is the disjoint rule, second one is the overlap. Let and disjoint rules. If the entity instance of the supertype is a member of the subtype, any of the subtypes, it cannot be simultaneously be the member of any other subtypes. Let if we are having instance of the patient's entity, that is also the member of any of the subtypes. Let patient is there, instance of the supertype, that is the members of the any of the subtypes, that outdoor patients or resident patients. It cannot be simultaneously be the members of any other subtypes. If patient is outdoor patient, that can't be resident patient as well. If patient is a resident patient, at the same time, the members of the subtype that can't be the member of any other sub entity type. So whenever we are having the disjoint rule is there, so member of one type that can't be the member of any other subtype simultaneously. So how we can represent it in the we have to use the D that is used for the disjoint rule. And next one, we are having another concept. Patient can either be the outpatient or resident, but not both at the same time. Second one, we are having the overlap rule. In overlap rule, we see that the entity instance of the supertypes can simultaneously be the entity instance of the supertype can simultaneously be the members of more than one subtypes. Or we can graphically represent, we have to use the N circle, we have to use the O. That is called overlap rule. Like here we say that if we are having the part is this, so that part can be manufacturing part or purchased part. So at the same time, that part can be the manufactured part as well as purchased part. So this one concept is called overlap. Part may be both purchased and manufactured. Now, next one we are having the concept of subtype discriminators. The attribute of the supertype that determine the target subtypes or the subtypes is called subtype discriminators. What we see, the attribute of the supertype, here we are having implied type, this one attribute of the supertype, it determine the target subtypes. Implied type, we see that for hirely employee we are using the H, for salary employee we are using CS, and for consultant we are using the C. So this one attribute of the supertype that determine the target subtype. So attribute of the supertype that determine the target subtype is called subtype discriminators. If we want to insert the instance of supertype, then into which of the subtype this one instance inserted or belongs. So for that one, we are having the concept of the subtype discriminators. Now here we are having the part types. Let me see that manufacturing, yes, or purchased, yes. Now another, we are having the supertype subtype hierarchy concept. We are having the person is the entity type. Person can be employee, alumni or students. So that can be person, share the common attribute. This one is a supertype having the different subtypes. So whenever we are having one subtype, that can also be a supertype. That employee can be a faculty or staff. Our student can be a graduate student or undergraduate student. So we are having the supertype subtype hierarchy concept is also there. Next one, we are having the entity clustering. It may be possible that we are having organizations that contain hundreds or thousands of the entity types and having their relationship. It become very difficult to read all of those entity types, to understand all of those entity types and their relationships. To handle this one problems, whenever we are having this large number of entity types and relationships, we have to create different ER diagrams which show the detail of the different segments. That will work, but that doesn't provide the complete picture of whole of the organizations. So to solve this one problem, we are having the concept of entity clusters. Set up one or more entity type, associate the relationship, group into the single abstract entity type. We are having the different set of the entity types. We have to group them into single entity types. Entity cluster behave like a entity type. Each entity type group to form a higher level entity cluster. From this one diagram, we are having the different type of the entities are there. We have to grip them, the different entity types, and forms the clusters. So this one is a concept of the entity clusters. Thanks for watching the video.